So I think this has had some of the most original and exciting play in any championship match for years, possibly going back to the Bronstein-Botvinnik match in 1951. When they play very hard-fought games like this, there are bound to be more errors than if one plays like Petrosian and puts the spectators to sleep.
I can quite understand that. And do you consider Fischer much stronger than Spassky?
Well, I wouldn't say that. I think, as I did before the match, that Fischer is stronger than Spassky. In this match, his inventiveness and originality in the openings has given him the advantage. I've always felt that despite his great strength in the attack and in the defense, that Spassky is not as tough a player to meet in the openings as many other grandmasters. And that is a disadvantage in a match like this.
Did you ever play Spassky?
Yes, I've played Spassky twice. I lost to him the first time and drew the second time.
The second time was in Moscow?
The second time was in the Alekhine Memorial Tournament last November.
And I presume with Fischer you played more than once, eh? So you're a countryman?
Yes, I can't even keep track of how many games we've played now. They've almost all been draws, great number, and he's won two and I've won one.
Oh, that's a perfect result. I congratulate you.
Thank you.
And how about the interzonal? Have you hoped to come into the interzonal?
Yes, I'm looking forward to the playoff with Kowalik and Ryshevsky to gain a place in the interzonal.
How many places of you three?
We have two places, so one player has to be eliminated.
And if you draw all together, but what will happen?
Well, then I win on the Sonnenborn-Berger tiebreak.
Nice.
Yes.
I hope you come into the zone.
Thank you
very much.
Nou, wat doen we hier? Zet je weer een pion op, hoor.
We've seen two Boris Baskis in this match. Boris of the first half and Boris of the second half.
That's right.
And I think that to put to rest all suspicion that he was psyched out or disturbed, we should have a return match.
Yes, and then, of course, but you said something about a revenge match. What do you mean by that?
No, I was just wondering whether the champion, if you recall, when Botvinnik was champion, the rules were changed so that the right to return match was taken away from him, and he got very angry over that. And,
I know that.
And I wonder what would happen if Fischer were to make the same demand to have a return match in the event that he lost a match, what FIDE would do.
We could do this, you know, I'm only the president of FIDE, I have nothing to say there.
Yes.
The Congress has to decide. As far as the regulations are now, it would be impossible, even the revenge match, but I think the Congress will be in favor of it. It is so in the interest of chess in general that they should do it, that there is a revenge match. But you think Bobby Fischer played all right in this match?
Yes, I think he got a little exhausted in the second half, and a lot of his openings were destroyed. He's going to have to go back to the workshop to find something new.
Yes, I saw that.
His knight-off variation of the Sicilian defense took a heavy pounding.
Yes.
And even today, he played pawn to king 3 on the second move for the first time in his life, I think.
Yes. So you think he needs some new preparation for the match, but this is very usual, you see, during the match, that your repertoire is hacked by the opponent. I remember for Elgin against me also, from time to time we wrecked each other's repertoires.
Well, they have to be refreshed now. I think at least a year or at least 9 months have to elapse between a match.
As a matter of fact, you also consider the opening as very important in such a match, the opening phase, the choice of the opening.
There's no question about it. As a matter of fact, I don't think that Fischer has really played the identical line twice in this match. He's kept mixing it up to keep Boris off balance.
Don't you think it's a little surprising that Fischer didn't beat Baski in the way he beat the others? He beat Petrosian and Larsen.
No, I don't. Spassky has obviously a stronger will and determination, which is beginning to show now.
And you don't think he was damaged by all this protest and so on? Don't think.
Oh, I think there's no question that Spassky was disturbed.
Was disturbed?
And shocked and put off his game. But I don't know whether it was intentional on Bobby's part.
I don't think it was.
I'm
sure it's not it is. Did you ever, you played many times, of course, with Fischer, huh? Mm-hmm.
Yes, I played him 6 times.
6 times?
Yes.
And how many games did you win, draw?
I lost 2 and drew 4.
Oh, that's fine. And against Spassky?
Against Spassky, I think I lost 1 and drew 2, drew the last 2.
Mr. Lombardi, I'm very pleased to see you today. And I know you're one of the very good friends of Bobby Fischer. And you know more than we know. And I should like to ask you, don't you think it is a disadvantage for Bobby that he has to do everything alone, or practical or alone? And the Russians have quite a team there, huh?
Well, it's always better to work with a team, and I think the Russians have realized this long before any Western player really became good enough to challenge their supremacy. But at the same time, I think Bobby is well aware that he needs help on the way to the chess crown, and he has had a great deal of help from various people, not only on the chessboard, but off the chessboard.
Oh, I see. I'm very pleased to hear that. What do you think about Bobby's play? Is it better than he used to play or not?
Well, I suppose when one considers the pressure that's on a player in a World Championship match, which lasts for 24 games, I consider the play reasonable. Some people have said that they feel that the play is really not up to standard or up to par, but I think that's nonsense. When we know as chess players the tremendous energy required for staying, the staying power required for 24 games, we can realize that these players are playing fine chess. And I think Boris has at last stopped making elementary blunders and has really put himself to the task. And his play has been very, very good, I think, over the last 10 games. And a few mistakes here and there, but very good chess generally.
After all, Boris is the first to stop Fischer to a certain extent, eh? Against Petrosian 6.5 to 2.5, and now Boris puts up a fight. Don't you think he played very well?
Right, I do. With all due respect to Bobby, I think Bobby is the greatest chess player in the world. But with all due respect, I don't think he invented the game. And I think it's quite possible for players, professional players, and really superb players as Spassky and other top players in the world to play good games and perhaps even score an upset against Bobby in a possible rematch, for example.
Do you hope there will come a rematch?
I do indeed hope that there will be a rematch, and Bobby has stated informally, he hasn't officially stated it, but he has stated informally to various people, I believe, that he's interested in promoting chess, and one of the ways of promoting the game is to have rematches, in other words, have a match for the World Championship on a more frequent basis, which namely would be once a year.
I quite agree, but of course it's up to the Congress of the FIDE to decide about these things.
Right, they would have to discuss the problem in the Congress and discuss it with the world champion if Bobby does indeed win the championship. I always consider the possibility that an upset could occur even when there's only one half point to go.
Yes.
But that's another point.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be interviewd by a world champion.
We zijn erg gelukkig dat we de gelegenheid krijgen om de hoofdarbiter, Mr. Lothar Schmidt, even voor onze microfoon te hebben. Hij heeft een aantal hele moeilijke maanden achter de rug. Ik zal hem daar allereerst iets over vragen. Mr. Lothar Schmidt, we are very happy to have you here for the microphone. I guess you are very satisfied that the thing is over.
That's true indeed.
It was a very tiring time for you.
For all of us, indeed.
For all of you. And what do you think about we have heard about many protests, of course, but were the protests, did they disturb the games?
No, not at all. The protests did not disturb the games, but otherwise it have been just enough protests here, and we have had to do much to solve these problems, to settle these problems. But I should say and point out that on the stage, the two players indeed have been good sportsmen.
Yes, so all the other things were behind the curtains.
That's so. Right.
And did you like the games?
Well, I think that many games have been extraordinary, interesting. A few of them have been not so good. It is
normal.
Quite normal, yes. Yeah. Wherever a match takes place, there are mistakes. And I think in the 8th game, in the 14th game, and maybe also in the last game, there have been mistakes. But that's human being.
In every match for the World Championship, they make mistakes, don't they?
Yes.
But do you think Fischer is the better player than Spassky?
Well, after all, maybe I am allowed to say so. Well, the result is 7-4. 7-3 only. And several draws. That indeed means that Fischer now, in that moment, is stronger.
Was there any player who could make 7 draws in succession with Fischer?
Indeed. Spassky is extraordinarily strong too.
Yes.
And perhaps in that moment he is the only one in the world who is able to make seven draws one after the other.
Yes.
But the future will show us some more.
We hope that there will be a revenge match, and then
it would be fine.
Maybe Spassky has better chances than in this match.
Yes, it is possible.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yes.
Wait a minute. I don't know.
Als we de wedstrijd, de match Spassky-Fischer, nu eens even in zijn geheel bezien, dan valt het op dat er een groot verschil is tussen de 10 eerste partijen en de tweede 10. Die eerste 10 partijen, daar heeft Fischer met 6,5, 3,5 gewonnen, eigenlijk met 6,5, 2,5, want een van die punten heeft hij nog gekregen door dat zijn tegenstander niet opkwam. Dus het is een aanmerkelijk verschil. We hebben toen ook gedacht dat Fischer zal hem helemaal wegvegen. Maar als u die tweede 10 partijen ziet, dan is de stand eigenlijk 5-5. Iedereen gewonnen en de rest 8 partijen remise. Niet zo wat we dan noemen salonremises, maar echt vechtremises. En wat voor conclusie kunnen we daaruit trekken? En ik geloof dat die conclusie ook wel eerder getrokken is. Spassky moet eerst een beetje wennen aan zijn tegenstander voordat hij echt op volle sterkte kan zijn. En dat hebben we in deze match nog wel heel duidelijk gezien. En als we dan verder denken en we denken aan een eventuele revanche match, dan volgt daaruit dat vermoedelijk in die revanche match Spassky betere kansen zal hebben dan in deze eerste match. Of de revanche met tot stand komt, dat weet ik niet. Er wordt heel veel over gesproken en het schijnt dat Fischer wel ervoor is. Een andere kwestie is natuurlijk of Spassky zelf wil, of zijn schaakbond er niks tegen heeft. Want ze zijn nogal erg verbitterd. Ze zijn een beetje boos over die vele protesten van Fischer. Maar we hebben het van Lothar Schmid kunnen horen. Ja, die protesten die waren er en die waren wel vervelend. Maar tenslotte, de spelers konden daar niet zoveel van merken. Hoogstens kan Spassky zeggen, ja, Fischer komt altijd maar een paar minuten te laat. Maar ja, dat is zijn eigen straf dan niet waar, want die minuten die verliest hij dan in zijn bedenktijd. Alles tezamen geloof ik ten eerste dat Fischer verdiend heeft gewonnen. Ten tweede dat als ze nog eens spelen, dat Spassky dan een aanzienlijk beter figuur zal slaan. Hoewel hij ook dit keer, vind ik, toch wel bijzonder goede dingen heeft laten zien.